Let's get right to the big elephant in the room here as Xi Jinping is about to speak tomorrow in response perhaps to some of the trade rhetoric and the tariffs that are proposed from the Trump administration. What do you expect or what do you hope to hear from President Xi Jinping tomorrow?
Well, first of all, I think BOAO is one of the most useful events that I come to. People are not necessarily very familiar with it, but this is the Chinese Davos. And you see the Chinese leadership here in their full glory, displaying their full colors.
And when Xi Jinping is here, they all come.
They all come. So it's a very important meeting. And of course, this is one of the first events of this type since Xi's presidency was reconfirmed. So I'm expecting some very strong statements from him tomorrow. China, of course, is wonderful for us in business out of the UK, because China has become a beacon of stability in a very troubled world at the moment. And the fact that Xi is prepared to give such strong authoritarian guidance within the context of a market economy is great for companies such as mine.
Do you see this tit for tat right now more than just rhetoric? How damaging is it to the global recovery from your perspective?
I think it's potentially it's very damaging. You know, Trump is the president of America, and it's very easy to disregard Trump. I always separate out people's personal feelings from Trump from what he is doing and what he's achieving. He has the democratic legitimacy of being the president of the United States. And when Trump speaks, odd though it may sometimes sound to people outside, he is speaking for a lot of Americans. So I think it's very important not to disregard what he says. One may have to slightly discount what he says, but one should never disregard it. And I think this US-China trade war thing is a very real thing on the horizon at the moment.
So it is a trade war?
It could potentially be a trade
war. What's the next step for you?
Well, I tend to look through the rhetoric to see what's actually happening on the ground in China. I have two major businesses in China, a life assurance business and an asset management business. Both are doing very well. My life assurance business, out of the maybe 100 insurance companies in China, so far this year is the 18th most profitable life insurance business in China. I'm very proud of that statistic. I have branches in 82 cities. I have probably the largest geographical footprint of any Western company in China. So when people talk to me about market access, I say, I have market access. I am doing the things that I want in China.